historical background of the third gender identity in India and the position accorded to them finds reference in the Hindu historical, Vedic and Puranic literatures. The concept of Tritya Prakriti or Napunsaka has also been an integral part of Vedic and Puranic literature. When Bhagwan Ram was leaving for the forest upon being banished from the kingdom for 14 years, when the Praja of Ayodhya followed him, he turned around to his followers and asked the men and women to return to the city. This is in reference that the Hijras did not feel bound by the direction of Bhagwan Ram and decided to stay with him. Bhagwan Ram was impressed with their devotion and he sanctioned them the power to confer blessings on people on auspicious occasions like childbirth and marriage, and also at inaugural functions, which it is believed set the stage for the custom of Badai, in which Hijras sing, dance and confer blessings. Jain texts also make a detailed reference to transgender, which mentions the concept of physiological sex. According to Tamil versions of the Mahabharata, Krishna took the form of Mohini and married Aravan. This was in order to give Aravan the chance to experience love before his death, as he had volunteered to be sacrificed. This marriage and death of Aravan are commemorated annually in a rite known as Thali, during which third gender take on the role of Krishna Mohini and marry, followed by an 18-day festival. The festival ends with the ritual burial of Aravan, while the Hijras mourn in Tamil style. However, during the British rule, the situation changed completely. Transgenders were knocked down to the lowest marginalized class. With the enactment of Criminal Tribes Act 1871, as shown in the slide, deemed the entire community of Hijras as innately criminal and addicted to the systematic commission of non-bailable offences. The Act provided for the registration, surveillance and control of certain criminal tribes and units, and had penalized units who were registered and appeared to be dressed or ornamented like a woman in a public street or place, as well as those who danced or played music in a public place. Such persons could also be arrested without warrant and sentenced to imprisonment for up to 2 years or fine or both. Under the Act of keeping a boy under 16 years in the charge of a registered eunuch was made an offence and punishable with imprisonment of up to 2 years or fine. However, the Act has been repealed in August 1949. The Honorable Supreme Court in the matter of Nalsa versus Union of India had given various directions to the state with regard to this community, such as treating them as third gender for the purpose of safeguarding their rights under Part 3 of our Constitution and the laws made by the Parliament and the state legislature. The right to decide their self-identified gender, such as male-female or as a third gender, to treat them as socially and educationally backward classes of citizens and extend all kinds of reservation in cases of admission in educational institutions and for public appointments, center and state governments are directed to operate separate HIV serosurveillance centers. Since transgenders face several sexual health issues and address such problems being faced by the transgenders, the above judgment was a turning point for this community. Recently, a PIL has been filed in the Supreme Court seeking equal protection of law to transgenders in sexual offence cases. It has been alleged that no penal provisions protect the third gender from offences of sexual assault. Our society often ridicules and abuses the transgender community in public places like railway station, bus stands, workplaces, malls, theatres, hospitals, where they are sidelined and treated as untouchables, forgetting the fact that the moral failure lies in the society's unwillingness to contain or embrace different gender identities and expressions, a mindset which we have to change. Today, we are here to understand the issues, social and legal, relating to this community who are still facing inequality in every sphere of life. But before moving to that, let us all celebrate some of the distinguished persons who broke the glass ceiling and went on to achieve amazing things in life. Their journey will definitely fill us with inspiration, especially in times like these when we are running low on hope. Joyita Mondal, July 8, 2017 marked a milestone of a new era for the transgender community when Joyta Mondal's white car with a red plaque stating Judgeship on Duty entered the premises of West Bengal's Uttar Dinajpur's Islampur Fort. Once forced to beg for a living, mocked and rejected at a BPO she worked at, to becoming a social worker on the bench for a national Lok Adalat, Joyta has always emerged victorious for her many struggles. Kalki Subramanian. This multi-hyphenated writer, activist, media personality and actor has been at the forefront fighting for transgender rights in India and took her message to a global platform when she was invited to speak at a two-day India conference organized by Harvard Business School and Harvard Kennedy School. Tara Shekha, appointed as Senior Associate, Human Resources by UST Global, a company in Thiruvananthapuram's Technopark, 29-year-old Zara Shekha became the first transgender person in the state to get a job in an MNC. Abina Aher. Abina Aher is an Indian transgender activist who has worked for transgender empowerment with organizations such as the Humsafar Trust Mumbai, Family Health International, Johns Hopkins University Center for Communication Program, and India HIV/AIDS Alliance. She is also an artist and founder of Dancing Queens, a dancing group of transgender people. Gauri Sawant. A transgender woman who forever broke the societal mold of motherhood pertaining only to women when she adopted a baby who stood at the risk of being sold to an agent after her biological mother passed away. Kajal. Born in the village of Mandya in Karnataka, Kajal, who was biologically assigned male at birth, suffered from the deep distress of gender dysphoria at a young age. After support, she left Mandya at the age of 10 and came to Mumbai. Following many years of struggle and social alienation, today she is the first transgender radio jockey of coastal Karnataka. Shilpi Lawrence. Shilpi Lawrence became a successful lawyer, breaking the shackles of discrimination despite the struggles of inequality. K. Prithika Yashini. K. Prithika Yashini made history when she became the first transgender person in India to assume the post of a sub-inspector in Tamil Nadu State Police. We appreciate them all for their courage and strength. Now together, let's sail this journey of liberation and pride.